Hello there, I'm Wesley Walker, founder of Walker Analytics. And today's video, we're going to discuss the rebranding of Google Data Studio to Looker Studio. If any of you are new to the channel, don't forget to drop a like down below if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more Looker Studio, Google Analytics, and Data Analytics videos in general. And hit that notifications bell so that you don't miss a single one of our uploads. So today, Google have rebranded Google Data Studio into Looker Studio. And the reason behind this is to consolidate all of the Google Cloud products into one, their business intelligence products into one. So we now have Looker Studio and Looker Studio Pro. So Looker Studio is essentially Google Data Studio with a different badge. Nothing has really changed under the hood. It's exactly the same tool as before. You get all the same visualizations, all the same UI, but the name has changed. So it's now part of the Looker family, a part of the Google Cloud family, so to call it. But it's exactly the same as Data Studio, so there's been no fundamental changes. Looker Studio is also still free, so you can still create your dashboards and visualize data for free in Looker Studio, just like you could in Google Data Studio previously. So there is also Looker Studio Pro, which is the paid version of Looker Studio, which people who have used Looker before will be quite familiar with. And this offers very similar functionality to Data Studio, but with enhancements for with enterprise level enhancements. Let's go through some of them now. So here we can see the article for Looker Studio Pro, and we can see that there's mention of Looker Studio products, and we see that there's mention of the Google Data Studio being changed to Looker Studio on today's date. Looker Studio Pro is a little bit more enhanced, but Looker Studio Pro is more for enterprise level users. And here are some of the features that you get with Looker Studio Pro. So Looker Studio Pro is the paid version of Looker Studio. With Looker Studio Pro, you get access to all the features of Looker Studio plus enhanced enterprise capabilities and technical support. One of those features is Looker Studio Pro makes it easy to manage access to your reports and data source at scale with two new features called Team Workspaces and Google Cloud Project Linking. And neither of these do you actually get with Google Data Studio. Within Team Workspaces are shared locations for team collaboration that enable Looker Studio Pro users to manage access and share Looker Studio content at scale. Members of a team workspace automatically access to the content, and specific permissions on workspaces depend on which role they are granted: manager, content manager, or contributor. So some of the advantages for this over Looker Studio and Data Studio previously is that you're able to share content at scale, whereas with Google Data Studio, you can share content to individual users and Google groups, but with Looker Studio Pro, you have access to Workspace, which is a bit more of a scalable way of sharing content with clients, internal stakeholders, or to other analysts that you can all work collaboratively on. This feature doesn't seem like too much of a upgrade for me from Google Data Studio, because you could get around having to add loads of individual people by using Google Groups. But Team Workspace is, I believe, a more efficient way of doing so. But to me, it doesn't seem like enough of a push alone to justify, you know, moving to the Pro version of Looker Studio rather than using the standard version. You also get to link Looker Studio to a Google Cloud project. So organizations can manage Looker Studio Pro assets through a linked Google Cloud project. Your Looker Studio Pro reports and data source belong to your organization rather than to individual users. This ensures that your critical assets will continue to work even if the person who created them leaves the organization. In addition, cloud administrators can set project level permissions with IAM to control access to those assets. So this is very useful because I have come across this issue many times with Google Data Studio, where I'm inheriting a dashboard from a previous analyst who's left the company and the dashboard breaks once they're kicked out of Google Analytics, for example. So with this being owned by the organization instead, should hopefully fix that problem. And if it does, that's a very useful feature already. And I know that I've worked with clients in the past that are quite concerned about me providing information for them, and then if for whatever reason they have to remove me in the future, the report breaking. So that is quite a useful feature already. But that is essentially it. So Google Data Studio is pretty much still here, but it's just been renamed to Looker Studio instead. And we now have Looker Studio Pro, which is a more enterprise version of Looker Studio, which was previously Google Data Studio. So let me know what you all think about the rebrand. Are you familiar with Looker? If you're familiar with Google Data Studio, let me know in the comment section down below, and I'll see you on my next video.